What's going on? It's your main man, Mr. Athletic Over Everything, Jason Mike, and we are at the Bench Hub. As I said in the first video that I released January 1st, I'm not sure exactly when this video is actually going to go out, but I did want to make sure that I started putting out more content, and we're going to start with this one because I've been getting the most feedback based on people finding out more about my process in terms of bench pressing. I don't do accessory work, or I haven't done accessory work in over 4 or 5 years. I don't do incline, I don't do decline, I haven't done all these other things, all these back exercises and things of that nature. So a lot of people just found it crazy that my bench press was able to jump from 545 pounds untested to where it's gone all the way up to 630 pounds. And if you look at my body weight composition has pretty much stayed the same. It hasn't gone up past 316. I think that's when I broke the IPF world record. I was about 316 pounds. But for the most part, I walk around about 290 pounds. Right now I'm about 287. So I've been on a killer streak. If you watch my Instagram, MrAthleticOverEverything.com, I basically have bench pressed 600 pounds 23 times in the last 45 days or something like that. I was actually testing out different methodologies, trying to see if they were going to work so I can better service my clients. You know, a lot of things people contribute to my bench success is that maybe I'm just a freak of nature, you know what I'm saying? In which I think there is some things to that, to where I am a little bit different. You know, everyone can't do what I do, but when I coach my athletes, I don't give them the same regimens that I do. I do change things up a little bit to work with their skill sets and where they are as athletes. But you always hear a lot of these coaches talk about big back, big bench, big back, big bench. I haven't done a back exercise in about 5 years, and my bench press has literally gained 70, 80 pounds on it, or some weird number like that, right? And I was trying to be careful in how I address telling people that I don't do accessory work, I don't do incline, I don't do decline, I don't do push-ups, I haven't done any of those things. What I will say, and this is something that kind of came to me later, is that before I stopped doing accessory work, my deadlift was actually better than my bench press. I was a over 800 pound deadlifter, and I was getting better. But when I moved over to the USAPL, there's no deadlift bar, and I had to learn a new deadlift. And I also have a unique deadlift approach where I actually jump in the air, land, grab the bar, and pull. That doesn't work the same with a stiff bar, and I had a bunch of trouble adjusting. So what I'm going to say now is, it's not so much that I don't think you need accessory workouts or they're bullshit. I think that with me stop doing accessory work actually killed my other lifts. My squat, 760, has been my best ever squat, and my best in competition is 750. My best pull ever is 815, and competition is 771. The 771 came with a stiff bar, but also I did it in a USPA meet, which caused me to leave, which was, it's a whole nother story. I don't even want to get into that. But going forward, this year, we're going back into the things that made me successful. I'm going to integrate a lot more exercises back into my programming, jumping, running, dunking, going back to all the things that made me what I am and what I was. I was a table tennis player before I started powerlifting. I actually just abandoned that cold turkey, but I'm actually going back to table tennis. You know, I want to play at least 2 to 3 times a week. I have a robot, and I can get in a lot of drills and things of that nature with the robot that we have here. One of the reasons why I actually stopped playing table tennis was because it affected my bench press. And I think that a lot of that was the fact of how I was training table tennis. I think I can avoid that, so I am going back to that. But this year for a block, I'm going to take on and do pull downs, tricep extensions, overhead extensions, more close grip bench work, curls, things of that nature. I have been doing research and watching some of the other coaches who are world renowned, and they talk about, you know, the size of your arms and things of that nature. And that's something that I actually think played a bigger part in maybe the missing link in what could get me over to that 300 kg that I'm aiming for on bench press, is the fact that when I started powerlifting, my biceps were 21 inches. Right now my arms are probably about 19 inches. I haven't done a curl probably in 4 years consistently. I did some earlier in the year, but as my deadlift got better, I used to do a thing where I almost was doing a curl with the bar. And I started seeing around this time a lot of people were tearing biceps, and it kind of scared me. So to counteract that, I stopped doing curls. So I'm starting to think that maybe accessory work might be something I need to do. And as I've noticed over the last couple of years, my deadlift has gotten less and less reliable over the period of time, whereas I could have always counted on a 750 deadlift. But over the last couple of years, all I needed was a 738 deadlift to come in second place to Ray Williams at Raw Nationals 1 year. I needed a 750 or 760 to total 2105, and I missed that an inch from lockout. I had what else? I needed 722 to win the championship, the IPF championship that we had over at Nauru last, like two years ago. I just needed 722, and I win the entire meet, best lifter and everything, and I couldn't lock the weight out. So I'm going back to fix those things. But I wanted to address the big back, big bench thing, because I'm not 100% sure that that is true, based on the fact that since I hadn't done any back work, my bench has gotten better. But the flip side of that is that my other lifts have gotten way worse. So I'm going to add those things back into my training just to make sure. But don't get so caught up into like the big back, big bench, big back, big bench. I think it just sounds good with a lot of what people say. But if it starts affecting other parts of your lifting, it affects your total. And at the end of the day, powerlifting is three lifts. Bench, squat, deadlift, total, you know what I'm saying? So don't be so concerned with the big back thing. Figure out what and how things are affecting you, because it can be something very small that you just stopped doing and it just ruined your entire total for a bench press. Now, I would not say I'd much rather have my big bench press than my big total. I like having both. So I am going to go back and start incorporating some of those other elements into my training in hopes to get my 800 plus deadlift back. Now, in this video, I'm going to make sure these videos are under 10 minutes, but I'm aiming to not only get back to an 800 plus pound deadlift, I want to get to a 400 kg deadlift by the end of this year. So I'm going to obsess about deadlift like I have about bench. I do believe my bench press is on cruise control right now. I think I can bench press 600 pounds opening up at any meet, any given time, and I just have to maintenance that. But on the flip side, I want to turn up my deadlift to improve my overall total. I do think I got 100 keys in me, and I'm 43 years old. I'm feeling good, and I think I have a lot more left in me. But yeah, so that's where we are with big back, big bench. I'm not going to say that is everything, but I'm not going to say that is nothing to the concepts as well. So I do plan on getting back to that. But if you guys got any questions, hit up the comments and I'll get with you guys. All right, until next time. Later.